G'day, it's Bergs, and welcome to my, the place that I call my little studio, my space, the studio in Mount Eliza in Victoria, Australia. I'm actually not here to talk about pedals or guitars today, although they will certainly feature. Today I'm here to talk about this, and this little system is actually a transmitter and a receiver, and it's called the Xvive U2 wireless receiver transmitter system. It's a guitar wireless. It has latency of less than 6 milliseconds, so they claim. It can be charged fairly quickly. I usually charge them in about half an hour. It has a line of sight operation of about 100 feet, which is plenty for big stages. I have been using it on massive stages, including this one that you can see on your screen, for the last couple of months, with absolutely zero problems, and I'm pretty damn flabbergasted because in Australia, at least, these run at $200 or less. They are four channels, so you can choose one of four channels. That means, I guess, you can have four of these up on stage at any one time. They run on the 2.4 gigahertz band, and it's just a matter of turning them on, letting them pair up, which they will do automatically, or you can actually manually tune them using the little channel button that you see on your screen. Just click it once for the first channel, twice for the second channel, etc., etc. The big test, of course, is how they compare to an expensive cable, which we all know and love, and the latency and the dropout rate, and if there are any or all issues with any of them, and I have to say that I've had experienced none. This is a broadcaster-style guitar. It's running through to an 18-watt tone setter amp built by Harry and the fellas in Queensland, actually, up at Vase. And it's got a gorgeous clear tone, which sounds like this. That tone is helped along by this Providence cable, which is Japanese and quite expensive, probably $70 or $80 in any Australian retail store. I haven't got a clue what they go for overseas, but they're not cheap. Okay, so let's put it on standby and we'll test out our Xvive system to see whether it's going to make the grade. So this is the transmitter. I plug it into my guitar and it has a swiveling jack, which means that it's going to plug into just about any type of guitar, and this being a T-style, it's got a slightly recessed input jack. There we go, in it goes. This is the receiver. This can go into your amplifier or your pedal board, whatever's appropriate. So we plug it in here, and all we've got to do is hit the little slider switch, turn it on, just let them pair up, which will take just a second, not long at all, in fact. There we go, the blue light is on and solid there. That means, hello, I can see you. Let's rock and roll. We put the amp off standby and we do this. Absolutely zero difference in the tone that I can tell from this guitar to that amplifier, and you know, it's a fairly tough test with single coil pickups and a guitar amp of that hi-fi quality. And there's no latency. Which was a big thing for me because I've experienced other wireless systems that are thousands of dollars more and, you know, they haven't been as great, I have to say. This, they claim to have 6 milliseconds or less of latency with this system. Now, the other big claim is that it has a 100-foot line of sight operational area. So I'm going to get up now and I'm going to keep playing and go for a walk at least another 30 feet or so and we'll see. And that, my friends, is why I love it, because it's sub $200. The price is kind of irrelevant when you're playing on huge stages and you need something that's reliable. This, for me, has been and continues to be reliable despite its exceptionally low price. It's just great. I can't recommend it highly enough. I know quite a few people who have adopted them recently and well, all of them, to my knowledge, are having success as well. It's the Xvive U2 system. Check it out. Thanks for watching. See you soon.